Welcome to Doggo.jl, your home for wholesome Julia tutorials. Double-click on the shortcut icon to open VS Code. Open the Explorer panel and create a new folder for this tutorial. I'm naming my folder Tutorial 10507, but you can name your folder whatever you like. In your new folder, create a new file. I'm naming my file math.jl. You can name your file whatever you like, but be sure to save it with a .jl file extension. Close the Explorer panel, and be sure that the autosave option is on. VS Code will save your settings from your previous sessions, so if you turned on autosave previously, it should still be on. You can tell that it's on if you see that check mark next to the autosave option. Before getting to the math, here's how to write comments inside of a .jl file. To write a comment, start the line with a hashtag character, also known as the number sign or the pound sign. Comments are human-readable notes that you leave for yourself and for anyone else who may be viewing your code. Comments are ignored by Julia, so you can write whatever you like. If you prefer, you can use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl/ to convert a line of code into a comment. You can toggle the line back and forth between code and comment by using Ctrl/ multiple times. In Julia, there's a special syntax for multi-line comments. Start the multi-line comment using #= and end the multi-line comment using #. All of the text in between will be considered a comment. Now that you know how to write comments, here's how to perform some basic math operations in Julia. Type in 1+1. Place the cursor at the end of the line and then hit Shift Enter. The Julia REPL will launch automatically, and you'll see the number 2 appear in both the REPL as well as next to your line of code. Being able to see the result next to your code is one of the convenient features of using Julia in VS Code. For the most part, you won't need to refer to the REPL, but it will continue to run in the background. I'm going to reduce the size of the REPL window by clicking and dragging this horizontal bar. This will give me a little more room to see my code. When typing in 1+1, I had to include a space before and after the plus sign. Those spaces are called white space. For the most part, Julia ignores white space, so you can also write 1+1 without any white spaces. I'm going to be using Shift Enter to evaluate my code, so I won't be constantly reminding you to hit Shift Enter. You get the same result, but the code is a little harder to read in the editor. There's a whole school of thought when it comes to the coding style guide, which I won't get into, but as a general rule of thumb, you should use whitespace to improve the readability of your code for you and your fellow humans. But for the most part, Julia and your computer are indifferent whether or not you use whitespace. For subtraction, use the minus sign character. For multiplication, use the asterisk character, also known as the star. For division, use the \/ character. Notice that Julia returned 2.0 and not 2. There's a reason for this that I'll cover in a future chapter. Now try to divide 5 by 2. As expected, Julila returns 2.5. For exponents, use the caret character. Caret is spelled C-A-R-E-T, and on most keyboards, it's shift number 6. So this is the code for 2 to the third power, or 2 cubed. The last basic math operator that I'm going to cover is the modulo operator. The modulo operator is the percent sign character. If you're new to coding, this is an operation that you may not be familiar with. Even though the percent sign character is used, this operation doesn't have anything to do with taking percentages. Instead, the modulo operator returns the modulus, which is the remainder of a division operation. So in this example, 5 divided by 2 equals 2, with a remainder of 1. That remainder of 1 is called the modulus of the operation, which is what you see in the result. This line of code is read 5 modulo 2, or 5 mod 2. You may be wondering why this is even necessary to use, but it turns out that the modulo operator is very useful in the coding world. Now let's put some of these basic math building blocks together with an example to demonstrate the order of operations. This code is the Julia representation of the math equation that you see on the screen. So reading this equation from left to right, while disregarding the order of operations, this is read 1 plus 2 minus 3 to the 4th power times 5. If you punch these numbers and operators into a calculator, literally from left to right, you'll get one answer. But if you follow the order of operations, you'll get a different answer. So if you use a calculator, that's 1 plus 2, which is 3, then 3 minus 3, which is 0, then 0 to the 4th power, which is 0, and then 0 times 5, which is 0. So by using a calculator, moving from left to right, the answer is 0. Let's see what Julia comes up with. Julia comes up with 6, not 0. Why's that? The order of operations can be summarized using PEMDAS, which stands for parentheses, exponentiation, multiplication and division, addition and subtraction. As a mnemonic device, PEMDAS is sometimes referred to as "Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally." So rather than simply going from left to right, you follow this order of operations. In this example, the operation in the parentheses is 2 minus 3, which is negative 1. The exponentiation is negative 1 to the 4th power, which is positive 1. The multiplication is 1 times 5, which is 5. And the addition is 1 plus 5, which is 6. So that's the answer that Julia came up with. In order to get comfortable working with basic math in Julia, try writing your own code using different numbers, and by combining the various operators. When you're done practicing, you can close out of the Julia REPL by clicking in the REPL. Then you can either use exit, immediately followed by a pair of parentheses, like you've done in the past, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl D, as in doggo, which is what I'm doing here. You can close the file by clicking on this X. And you can close out of VS Code by clicking on this X. VS Code will save your UI settings, so you won't need to readjust them every time. So that does it for basic math. In the next chapter, you'll learn what a Boolean is, and how to use them in Julia.